Sorry for dropping. Looks like more anti-coal people are starting to show up. Honestly, I think they were paid to be out here because they're wearing corporate t-shirts, and Bill Tagami's got a lot of money, so I wouldn't doubt it. But the anti-coal people are outnumbering the pro-coal people by about 2-1. There's about about 100 anti-coal and about 50 pro. So, and the pro people are trying to say that the coal terminal is going to bring in a lot of jobs. But what good is a job going to do you when environmental studies have already said that coal in Oakland is a really bad idea? It's going to poison the air there even more and cause many more health problems for people living here. So a job's not going to do you any good if you're not helping. So maybe, you know, why do we have to ship coal through the terminal in the first place? There's plenty of other cleaner, greener solutions. As coal, as you know, is probably one of the most dirty things you can pull out of the ground. And to burn it or to use it in the steel process is a known cause of acid rain and a whole host of environmental destructive. Environmentally destructive. And as somebody who cares about the environment, I think that it's a pretty wise move to move away from coal. You know, all the stuff about mountaintop removal. And let's face it, Peabody Coal, one of the biggest coal companies in the United States, they recently went Chapter 11. So the coal industry is in steep decline in America today. And that's why we have to stop this terminal here in Oakland. Let's keep it going. Let's bankrupt these out-of-date, notoriously corrupt fossil fuel companies whose only job, it seems, is to poison the earth. Anyway, enough of my rant. I'll check and see if anybody's chatting. Let me know how the audio-visual is if you're logged on. Talking about coal, and I'm a cigarette smoker, but this is for future generations. By the way, the union, which will be doing most of the shipping coal, the International Longshoremen Workers Union, has come out against this coal terminal. So, if they're against it, the economic value of this is highly debatable. Had to put something away. We're down here at Oakland City Hall for those of you just joining us. And this is your live streamer, Freeman Sullivan. Happy that you're aboard. We're here right before Oakland City Council meeting that's going to vote on whether there'll be a coal terminal shipping coal from Utah out of Oakland to most likely China and overseas. And be burned to poison the air, basically. Here in a second. people are going to go inside. I'm not going to be going in. Thanks for joining us. We're down here at Oakland City Hall for No Coal in Oakland. So here's all the pro-coal people. Well, looks like people are going to be going inside. At any rate, glad you could join us. Best I could say is that a lot of corporate money involved. This supposed project is supposed to generate $450 million a year in revenue for Phil Tagami's corporation, which is over there in the building next to the big blue glass one. The beige and black window, the black windows, and but environmental study was just released the other day, and says that the shipping coal dust and coal through West Oakland is toxic to the environment. Oh, big news there! And do we really want a bunch of coal trains running all the way from Utah here to the Bay Area? So I'll be tweeting a little bit later to let you know the result of the vote at Freeman Sullivan, so you can find out because they don't. I don't know if my my camera will work inside. So. For more information about this, you can go to Facebook. Do a search for No Coal in Oakland. And you can find out more information about what is going on with this rally. And the other group, well, I got a picture of their T-shirts. It's American for something energy. Right, man. Patriots for energy or some crap. Alrighty, folks. Hey, thanks for joining me. I'm physically feeling a little bit better. So I'm going to be coming out and covering more demonstrations and protests from the Bay Area. And this is your live streamer, Freeman Sullivan, signing off.